Welcome back, students. We have completed OFDM in the last class. Now we will learn about architecture of 3G cellular system. Okay, architecture of 3G cellular system. Okay, you know that 3G means we are using the technology UMTS. So along with the GSM architecture, we will learn about the UMTS architecture also. Okay, or the advancement in the UMTS architecture. Anyway, you know that in 2G, we have in 2.5G, 2.75G, we are using the technologies GPRS and edge technology. Okay, these things we have referred in unit 1 anyway, in the evolution of a cellular system topic. We have learned about 1G to 5G communication system, the technologies used and the features with respect to each generation. So anyway, here we are learning about the architecture of 3G cellular system. Okay, so the 3G cellular system consists of two parts. Okay, that is the user equipment UE. Okay, user equipment UE and the UMTS, terrestrial radio access network. Okay, UMTS. I have to make a note. UMTS is given universal mobile telecommunication system. Okay. UMTS means Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. UMTS stands for U, okay, Terrestrial Radio Access Network, okay, UTRAN, okay. So by using the UMTS technology and using respect to radio access network, we are designing a 3G architecture in an effective way. Okay, see, the GSM architecture is same. Along with the GSM features, here not increase the speed, not establish the video calling, and not increase the data rates, right? So we are interfacing with respect to UMTS technology. Okay, that's why it consists of two parts. One is the user equipment and the UTRAN. Okay, means UMTS, terrestrial radio access network. Here the user equipment is nothing but a mobile phone. The UE is a mobile phone, and UTRN is the base station. UTRN is the base station and the network intelligence. Network intelligence means how it will act with respect to the communication unit. Anyway, the UTRN is the new radio access network designed especially for UMTS. See, remember that UMTS means that is a 3G technology. Okay, that is Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. And UTRN consists of radio access controller, radio network controller, RNC, ATRAN, UTRAN. ATRAN consists of radio network controller, okay, that is RNC, and node B. Okay, there are node B's will be there, which acts as a base station. And together the node B and the RNC, combined to form a radio network subsystem, which will be seen in the next slide. Okay, which is seen in the next slide. And the internal interface of UTRN include IUB and IUR. Okay, these are nothing but interface names. Okay, B is between the node B's and R is between the RNC's. Anyway, we'll explain those things. And IUB connects a node B to RNC, and IUR is a link between two RNC's. So this is the figure, this is the UTRN components and interfaces, this is nothing but the architecture of 3G. You can consider it as an architecture. Architecture of 3G. These are the architecture of 3G. UTRAN, components and interface. Here the core network. See, here the core network is nothing but our GSM architecture. Okay, I repeat, core network is nothing but our GSM architecture. It consists of these base stations. Okay, MSCs, BSCs, HLR, VLR. Okay, all these things. These are the core network. So this is the additional equipment or that additional technical architecture we are going to interface combined with respect to GS, right? So ATRAM consists of node B's. We already discussed node B. These are the node B's. 1, 2, 3. 3 node B's are there. Here 3 node B's are. The interface is nothing but IUB. Okay. U for stands for UTRAM. B for between the node B's. And here IUB. Same. Okay. And interface between two RNCs. RNC is said to be IUR. U stands for UTRAM UMTS. R stands for RNC. You can remember like that. Okay. Here, here also interface between ATRAN and C. So I suffix U. So this is the IU. And coming to IU, in IU between B. So IUB. Here between R and C. So IUR. So it is easy to remember the names, interface names. IU, IUB, node B's, IUR, R and C's. Okay. So this is about the architecture of 3G. Now, let us discuss about the components and the features. These are nothing but a statement. If you listen evolution of 3G cellular system, very easy to understand. Just we are mentioning what are the services, what are the functionalities provided by node B and what is meant by RNCs. Because these are only the additional parts we are going to discuss here. Remaining things were all discussed in GSM architecture. GSM architecture, we have discussed many things. Okay, that, those are all consist in the core network. If we want to discuss additionally about the core network, you need to write about the GSM architecture. That's your wish, right? So, you know, if you want to write about the core network, you can write about the NSS, okay, network and switching subsystem, about HLR, VLR, GMSC. You can write about those things when you want to write about the core network, right? So I am discussing about the additional equipment only, that is about RNC and node B. So radio network controller, RNC. Radio network controller, RNC. So it is comparable to a BSC and GSM, and functions that are performed by RNC include the following, that is IUB interface. UB between the node B's, okay, acts as a resource management and control of node B logical operation and maintenance, that is operation O and maintenance O and M resources, and it used to control the logical resources with respect to operational maintenance management, and the system information management and scheduling of system information. These are all the functions provided by the RNC. Okay, transport resources management, operation and maintenance management, and system information management and scheduling of system information, traffic management of common channels, okay, traffic management of common channels, macro diversity means nothing but a space diversity, okay, how a single signal is transmitting and receiving by the antennas, space diversity, all show you about space diversity antennas. So splitting of data streams transferred over several node B's, and modifications of active sets about the soft handover, and allocation of DL means downlink channel codes, and uplink outer loop power control, and downlink power control, admission control, reporting management, traffic management of shared channels. Okay, these are all the functions provided by the RNC. You need to remember these points about the functionalities provided by the RNC in addition to the core network. And about node B, what is the functionality of the node B? Node B is the UMTS equivalent of base station transceiver. And functions that are performed by node B include the following. Okay, it also implements the operational management and mapping of node B logical resources into hardware resources, and transmitting of system information messages according to scheduling parameters given by RNC. Okay, according to scheduling parameters given by RNC, node B is to transmit the respective system information messages. And about the macro diversity, combining splitting of data streams internal to node B, I already mentioned about macro diversity, nothing but the space diversity antennas. Okay, how a signal is transmitting and receiving by the respective antennas. And uplink inner loop power control, and reporting of uplink interface measurements and downlink power information. These are all the functions provided by the node B. So this is about the architecture of 3G cellular system. Okay, this is about the architecture of 3G cellular system. So here I have discussed only about node B and RNC, RNC functions, and about node B functions. You can write also about core network, but core network is nothing but the GSM architecture. We have already discussed about the GSM architecture. So if the question is asked about architecture of 3G cellular system, you can simply write about the GSM core network, that is GSM architecture. Some points you can write, and you can write about RNC functionalities and node B functionalities. Okay, this is about the architecture of 3G. And at last, we will discuss about the features of 3G cellular systems. Okay, what are the features of 3G cellular system? Anyway, in unit 1, evolution of cellular system, I have already discussed about 3G technologies and 3G features. Okay, anyway, in unit 6, the question is asked about features of 3G cellular system. I am again repeating with respect to the question. So the speed is of 2 megabytes per second, and there is an increase in bandwidth and data transfer rates with respect to the 2G, and you can send and receive large email messages, and it has a large capacities and broadband capabilities with respect to 2G. Okay, here the topic is about 3G architecture and features. Means I am comparing or representing the 2G with respect to 3G. And new radio spectrum to relieve overcrowding in existing system, because you may think that there is a 4G technology, why there is this point, send or receive large email message, because here the in our unit, okay, we are highlighting the 3G one, right? See, there is a given architecture of 3G, we have to mention about the features of 3G with respect to 2G, right? So more bandwidth, security and reliability, interoperability between service providers, different service providers, means portability, nothing but porting, and fixed and variable data rates, asymmetric data rates, backward compatibility of devices with existing networks, and always online devices. 3G will use IP connectivity, which is IP is, you know, IP is a packet based one, and it consists of rich multimedia services. Okay, these are all the features of 3G cellular system. Thank you.